How can you believe in God without evidence? Is there any evidence that God exists, or is it all just a fantasy of naive people who need a religious crutch to get through life? In the 13th century, the Italian theologian Thomas Aquinas wrote what many people consider today the classical arguments for God's existence. These arguments are complex, they're philosophical, they're not so easy to understand, and they have difficult names like the cosmological argument or the ontological argument. And instead of going through them in detail, we will put a link in our YouTube description to a different video that explains these arguments in some detail. But let me today go through a modern version of Aquinas' argument from design. If you walk down the mountain and there's bushes and stones and rocks, and all of a sudden you discover a Rolex watch. You pick up the watch and you say, wow, this watch is very intricate, very complex. It's not like anything else here on the mountain. It speaks of something that was created, something that was designed because of its complexity. And Thomas Aquinas said, when we look at our world around us, there's such a complexity, such an intricacy of different systems working together exactly. It speaks of a great designer. And a modern version of this argument goes like this. In 2001, the very famous world-class cosmologist, Mr. Sir Martin Rees, wrote the following book. The book was called Just Six Numbers, The Deep Forces That Shape the Universe. And in this book, he isolated a few key numbers that are fundamental to our physical universe. These numbers are very big or very small. They're not the kind of numbers we use every day in our normal going to work and living. One such number is a number that he called N, and it's a huge number, right? It's it's one with 36 zeros behind it, so it's a long number. And this number measures the strength of the electrical forces that hold atoms together, divided by the force of gravity between them. Okay, what does any of that mean? For our discussion, it doesn't really matter what it means. What's important is that if N was even just a little bit different, there would be no life in our solar system. There would be no planets, there would be no oxygen, there would be no life. N is exactly the number it needs to be to support life. And Martin Rees said that's just one number. There are six of these numbers that are so perfectly fine-tuned for life, it almost looks to us like that Rolex watch. As if someone, a grand designer, created this universe, this solar system, and this planet to exactly be able to support human life. How is that possible? And so Martin Rees says, well, there's three options that we have. The first option is that we are just incredibly, incredibly lucky, right? Evolution just worked itself out in such a way that we are very, very lucky. But Martin Rees says, that is so unlikely, it's so astronomically small that that would happen. He doesn't think that's the case. Second option, Martin Rees says, maybe there is a creator, maybe there's a God who fine-tuned the universe for human life. But Martin Rees is an atheist. He does not believe that. He says, it is, however, a reasonable thing to believe, and some of his colleagues, some of his fellow astronomers, cosmologists, do believe this, even though he does not. And the third option is what many people today call the multiverse theory, where they say, well, our universe is exactly perfect for life, but we are just one of billions of different universes, and all of them have different numbers where life are not supported. And we ended up in the one universe where these numbers are just perfect. That's called the multiverse theory. It's the go-to theory that many people today use in order to explain the fine-tuning of our universe. Very conveniently, of course, we cannot test this theory since we are stuck in this universe. For me personally, the idea that God created our universe to support and sustain life is much more feasible, and it speaks to me to this idea. Oftentimes, arguments for God's existence can only get us so far. 80 or 90% of the way. The rest is trust and faith. We do this in human relationships, right? If my wife says to me, I love you, and I ask her to prove it to me, she can try and prove it to me over years of being faithful and loving me. But at the end of the day, an element of faith, of trust is still needed, where I say, I believe you when you say you love me. And this is the same in our relationship with God. Arguments can bring us 80 or 90% of the way, but faith and trust is also needed.